So when I was younger, my mom and I would usually choose my outfits before school, and this was usually a really fun process for me, but there'd be a few occasions where she would choose it, and there was this one outfit I absolutely hated. It was a little brown leather skirt with a leopard print long sleeve, and so whenever I had to wear this, I would start crying because I like really hated it, and I was like, I would always hope that she would change her mind, but she never did, so I go to school wearing it. And so obviously my defiance was not effective at all because it was expected. And so today I'm going to talk to you about a time in history where the French used a creative way to show their defiance. So during the Nazi occupation of Paris, the French had no control over their lives. They basically had to do whatever the Germans wanted them to. And so one of the things that the Germans did was they enacted a monetary exchange rate that was ridiculous, and it was to their advantage. So the Germans could come to Paris and they could buy all the luxury goods that they wanted and eat at the best restaurants for only a small percentage of the actual price, while the French had to wait in long lines to get their food rations. And so another thing, during the peak of the war, the Germans wanted to move the Paris fashion industry over to Berlin in order to generate more money. And so the French opposed this strongly just because they said that there's no way they could produce their clothes anywhere else other than Paris. And so Lucien Leelong, he was the president of the Chamber of Couture at the time, he went over to Berlin and basically told them all the reasons why they couldn't move it. And so he ended up arguing so strongly that the Germans receded and they allowed them to stay in Paris. So one thing that the Germans did enact was a clothing ration, and so all of the French were given a certain amount of clothing coupons, and you could exchange these for a certain amount of clothing items, so this amounted to about 3 or 4 per year. And so this was something that the Parisians were not used to at all. And so the French designers decided to begin using this rationing law to their advantage. So they wanted to defy the French, or the Germans, by creating designs that had a lot more fabric than was necessary. So see here, they had the longer hemlines and the big bows, the ruffles across, and it was all just to show that they weren't going to comply. And so another way that they did this was through turbans. And so the French women wore turbans for two reasons. The first reason was that they had to limit the amount of water they used, so they could only shower a few times a week. And so they didn't want to show their like dirty hair, so they would hide it in these turbans. And they also found out that they could begin using more fabric in these turbans, and they could use patriotic colors to show that they still had pride in France, even though it was under occupation. And so the third reason that, or the third way that the Germans were able to, or the French were able to defy the Germans, was that the Germans basically demanded that the French couturiers dress the upper class German woman, and so they would use designs that made them look ridiculous. So they see here, they have like two different prints making up a skirt, or they gave them like huge headpieces that at the time was very radical, and like no one would wear that. So the German woman didn't come back to Paris, which was the whole point of doing this. And so 2 years after the war ended, the French designer, Christian Dior, he decided to embrace this sort of defiance through the new look. And so this was very different from anything that was designed at the time, because the rationing law was still on. And so he used a lot of excess fabric in his skirt, but he still wanted to embrace the femininity of the women, just because they had moved on past the war. And so this was very successful for everyone because it showed that France wasn't going to basically just look over what they had done, but embrace the fact that they defied the Germans at the time when everyone felt like they couldn't. So why is this important? Well, the French were able to defy the Germans at a time when, if there was a time of despair. And so this showed to the world that even at a time where it seemed that they couldn't do anything, they showed their defiance through something as simple as fashion. Thank you.